We're going to assault the Baikonur Cosmodrome. The thing is, there is currently a real spaceship named Buran. And the Energy M rocket is ready for takeoff. We want to get there to revive it, to supply power to the onboard network from this battery with an inverter. The problem is that it is well guarded. So we got infrared flashlights, camouflage gear, so we could crawl into the space hangar at night. For this difficult mission, we chose a special domestic vehicle.
That's it. Now this work of art can be called Creo UAZ. Awesome.
Super.
Now meet our guide to the Cosmodrome. He's Reinhardt. Well, let's go now. In the 80s, Soviet scientists built the world's finest unmanned reusable spacecraft and named it Buran. The test flights have exceeded all expectations. Buran made two turns in orbit around Earth and independently, without the help of a pilot, landed on a point with an accuracy of only 1 meter. But for some reason, this incredible space program was frozen and Buran was mothballed. And we are going now to that very hangar to see this miracle of engineering with our own eyes and launch it. Oh, guys, now you'll see what we can do. So, guys, well, we are moving through Kazakhstan, Anton. Could you remind me what is the name of the city?
Kayseri.
Have you ever heard that such a city exists? Well, that name, guys. The weather is just great, perfect for breaking in Baikonur. How do you like our Kamaz? It's a bomb. We even have a spinning in here. We're going straight up, right?
This is a super vehicle.
Guys, we found a small store. Now we're gonna buy everything we need. This is the most important thing in any trip. Take some more. Take more. Okay, come on, give me a Coke.
All we need now is sausage.
The sausage must be somewhere in that direction. Our followers are gonna hate on Anton for such boorish attitude. Guys, do you think this is normal behavior in the supermarket for a blogger or not? See how crazy prices are here. This plastic costs so much. What kind of cheese is this? Do they sell cheese and beer?
No, I mean, this word means beer in Kazakh language.
Oh, man.
Take water, gentlemen.
What? Is this for the radiator?
Yes, yes, yes. This is just in case. We'll use it instead of antifreeze.
Excuse me, but can you tell me if you have cold smoked meat here?
Meat, right?
Yeah.
Here, at the grocery department.
Wait, guys, horse meat. Canned horse meat. How do you like that? This is Kazakhstan. Such a delicacy costs 800 tenge.
Yes, yes, we love horses. Do you know how many horses I've eaten in my life?
You won't find such a thing in Russia. Homemade kazi. Anton, what is kazi?
Kazi is a horse sausage.
Yes, they make everything of horses here. Look at how many different ones there are. It's so hard. Have you guys ever seen the national Kazakh pasta?
They're called kispeya.
It says zaima. Well, for some reason, they were always called kispeya. Look at the pasta. It's so flat.
I do not know.
Just at home cooking.
Hello, everyone.
Will we take vodka?
Wait, why do we need vodka?
Well, we don't drink it.
Then why do we need it?
Well, ask him. He's our conductor.
If we get to gold, we'll rub ourselves with vodka.
Oh, so this is for the safety, right?
We'll rub each other then.
My impression of this store in Kazakhstan, the city of Kayseri, is very cool. They sell many exotic strange things though. That's odd. You've seen how narrow-eyed the locals are.
And everyone looks at us like we're morons. Like, what does he do? Why is he talking to the camera?
Actually, it is 50 kilometers on foot to the launch pads of Baikonur. But we decided to cheat and go there by car, directly through the steep.
I hope we don't get caught.
Don't think it's dirt. It's a disguise. That is, we will merge with the ground, guys. Look at the plate, the lights, the windows, everything will merge with the nature. We won't be visible from afar away. We will drive 170 kilometers on such a great road, and then we will turn into nowhere. We will have to overcome a huge moat, and in fact, this is the border of the territory of the Baikonur Cosmodrome.
See how the landscape changes? Do you feel the south now? Look, the field is so wide. Look, someone's running.
There's a dude running.
Maybe he's a hitchhiker, Sasha.
Yes, there are also road bandits here, so you need to be more careful.
Ah, oh, you fool. What's he doing? What is it?
Stop.
Who are you?
Hey, who are you?
Why don't you slow down?
What nonsense?
Where are you going? Let's go, quickly.
Give me the keys.
Take the keys from me.
Who the hell are you?
I'm from the unit.
What unit?
What's going on?
I'm being chased. Can you just move?
Start it up. Let's go.
I'll explain everything later. My name is Salim.
Salimhan?
What's wrong? Did you run away? Like a deserter?
You don't believe I'm a colonel.
Yes, you're not a colonel.
Hands off.
It's a toy, you kidding?
Can you imagine? They make us wipe the floors, like everywhere.
Well, the main thing is that they don't force you to wash the toilets.
This happens all the time, do you understand?
Is it tough? It's too sweet. Well, please take me. Just kidding, guys, just kidding.
Vadim Vadimich is coming with us. We're going to conquer Baikonur. We played such a small scene to amuse you. Sure to award us with a like.
Well, the boys really tried hard.
I'm a colonel.
Colonel? Are these asterisks?
Yes.
We'll go a little straight ahead. There will be one gas station there.
The last one?
Yes, the last one to refuel on.
It's nice to have two tanks, you know.
So we are approaching the second one.
They have 90-second gasoline.
Great.
Can't fool this one. Go to the third pump.
Strange. The gun clicks off.
Yeah, got it. We need to turn around.
Oh, it's all good.
What can you say about the super stalking UAZ?
You can live here. It's really very cozy, like awesome.
How do you like this? Do you know why we're taking this?
No, why?
We will lower the spinning rod into the shaft.
Really?
With a camera.
And what do you want to catch there?
We want to catch a doll there.
No, I'm just kidding.
I told you yesterday about this doll.
What? How much do I owe?
3,800.
By the way, the gasoline in Kazakhstan is extremely cheap.
Well, the price fell significantly. We refueled for 35 liters and paid 3,800 tenge.
That's about 750 rubles. And in Russia, we would pay about 1,000 rubles for 35 liters. Something like this. Saved a lot.
You know, after your words, somewhere in Ukraine people are crying. How much is gasoline in there?
It's 45 hryvnia.
They go to Russia for gasoline and pass through the border.
Oh, what a heat.
Oh, the engine works well. But the weather is actually insane today.
Again, this truck is in our way. Why is it going so slowly?
It looks like it's loaded.
Did you hear that? Did they come for us?
Yeah, are the lights on?
Yes, of course, of course.
This one.
He's stubborn.
Does he even feel it?
He does.
He scratches it.
Look, he's violating the rules. He's overtaking us on a solid road.
If there was a police, find him.
Kazakhs do not know how to drive at all.
Oh, what a hot oven.
What is it?
What is touching me?
Pull up your fishing rod.
Oh, that's all right. The flow was rubbing my hand.
Whoa, crazy. Overtake him. Toha, overtake him.
Good job, Dora.
Vadim!
That's it, you've got it.
Prank was successful.
Well, guys, we've stopped.
That's insane. This is the second stop. The car is warming up. I don't understand what's going on. We'll cool down for 10 minutes and then everything will be fine.
We were refueling at a gas station and gasoline leaked out. We started looking for a problem where the gasoline is leaking out. It turned out that the thing is in a hose. We don't know which one.
I think it's the reverse.
It moves the gas from one tank to another. There are two of them here, right?
No, it's an overflow.
An overflow?
There's a hole in it.
Can you show me this hole?
Look, do you see it pouring?
Is that what it is? Does it really pour out?
Well, yes, here it is. This cut, the gap.
Slava says that the whole problem is in the hole.
Slava is delirious.
Anyway, guys, we've been arguing the whole way. For some reason, the car overheats and does not go. Anton, is there a problem with the hole?
No, not in the hole.
Yeah, don't shoot me. Why are you shooting? I want to understand what the problem is and try to solve it.
Weird stuff, actually.
Imagine if it's really about to hold.
You know, we have 5 to 10 minutes to do something. It won't get any worse. Well, if you don't want to, it can stop as we did before.
We should try it.
Well, try it as it starts. Start it up smoothly. Does it pull normally?
Now, let's see.
Yes, it's fine. Let's go. What are they doing here? What the hell is going on? What are you doing?
Cool down, let's go.
If there were problems with the pressure, it wouldn't go at all. Guys, look, here are some horses. We decided to find a shepherd to ask him the way to Baikonur.
Now go take a look. Wow, the wind is strong. Oh, the horses.
Yurt? Where?
For some reason, I don't see the shepherd.
Guys, there's no shepherd. There's a real yurt there.
There's a yurt. Look to the left.
There, round one.
Damn, we have to stop by. Yes, there's the road on the left. This is insane.
There's a real yurt there. Wow.
I'm not going anywhere.
Why don't you go? Don't you like these yurts?
I'm not going. I'm not going to the yurt. I'll guard the car.
What? Are you afraid of them? Do you think they'll beat you?
Of course no.
Stop. Let's go. Yes, we'll go on the grader now.
Anton, do you think they know the way to Baikonur?
Yes, they should know anyway. They're local. I'm just worried that they might not tell me. Or, well, damn, they probably won't call the cops and turn us in.
I think, well, the people here are just honest and kind. Therefore, I hope they'll help us.
Binoculars, urgently!
Bro, it's behind you. I prepared everything there. Is it a yurt or a house?
Yes, a round yurt.
No, it's a house.
A house.
Sad. Well, it's just here in the middle of nowhere.
Where are the yurts? Why don't we come across real yurts?
Damn, from afar it looks like yurts.
They put them only in Noriz, and Noriz is on March 22. What is Naliz?
Naliz is here.
Noriz, new year. It's a new year.
And where is the round one that we saw? Or is that what it is? From a distance, it seemed round.
Man, just one house here in steep.
Are there any dogs?
Look.
The solar panel. Look how big it is.
Look.
It is directed to the south and the west. This is what the Kazakhs live like.
There.
She literally jumped up.
You scared the woman.
Wow, cool, right?
How
are you? Hello, we're tourists.
Yes?
Came from far away. We're heading to Baikonur.
Baikonur?
Yes.
Cosmodrome.
Do you know the way?
Here, take this road straight ahead, then onto the highway.
Will they let us through if we just go by?
I don't know.
We saw your house from the highway. How do you live here?
We have sheep.
How did you install these solar panels?
Builders.
Builders? And does it produce enough electricity?
Yes, it is enough.
It's freaking awesome. Do you want one of these?
Yeah.
Is that more economical than electricity? Here is no electricity that we used to.
Of course.
Don't you want to leave?
No. We are retired, so we want to live here.
Tell me, do you mind if we shoot a tour?
Well, we've never seen something like that. We ourselves came from far away.
Where did you come from?
We came from Russia.
Here's a guy from Ukraine.
Tell me, can I climb into the hayloft?
Well, sure.
Take pictures.
Yes, take photos.
Wow, cool.
Well, these are strong panels, new ones. You see 300 watts each, I think.
They're solar.
Do you wipe them, though?
No, no.
Don't wipe it.
In the winter, we will wipe.
From the snow, 10 pieces. Can you imagine?
Wow.
The total power is probably 3 kilowatts. Seems to me that for this house is just enough.
That's a lot, but they seem to have refrigerators or some kind of powerful consumers. Therefore, the panels are huge.
The antenna is probably for the internet. They also have a satellite system hanging over there. That is, they have a satellite TV. I wonder, do they have 4G here?
Oh no, here's no connection.
You see how the Kazakhs live? It's just awesome. The house is made of hay and clay, isn't it? Plain slate roof. Own cattle, sheep, chickens, your coal, your hay, such a civilization with an internet.
Wow.
You're like their god. You go and they all follow you. Wow.
How many times a day do you feed them?
Three times.
Three times a day?
Are they so glutinous?
Do you have anything to repair?
Panels.
Help? Do you need any help?
Are the panels working properly? We're just good at it. We have a scientific channel.
Everything is fine. These two batteries do not work, or something.
But this is their frequent problem. They often require replacement.
You don't know?
I know that, yes. This is a problem of these solar systems.
There's something humming.
The woman goes and the chickens follow her.
Yes, I can hear you.
There's probably a cow in there.
Look, not a single tree.
Let's go there first.
What a wild roar.
Vadim, over there, at the very top, guys. How easy is it to climb in there? Do you want masterclass?
Tan, how did you fail?
Wow, are you Morin or something?
Sorry.
It's like a sandpaper, you know?
Don't fall down, Toha.
Look at the steep, guys. It's just insane. Do you know how to get out of here?
Look, it's vibrating.
Wow, Vadim is a roofer.
Thank you for your hospitality. It's very futuristic.
That's where we're going, right?
That way.
To Baikonur.
Over there.
Come on, Toh, get started. Just happen like this. Come on, come on, Toh. You've forgotten me. Wait.
Sanya, what are you doing?
Sanya?
Thought you were in the car.
That's it. We're going to Baikonur.
Damn, unfortunately, she doesn't know the exact route.
She doesn't know if it's possible to drive to Buran.
But she told us the route and how to get there.
It seems to me that on the way, we should ask the shepherds from the locals.
Should I do a short car tour?
Yeah, sure.
Anton, what can you say about the car?
What are these levers?
In short, this is a distributor it turns one.
Rear axle.
Rear axle. Yes, that is.
We have a 4x4 like an SUV.
A speedometer that doesn't work,
but it won't upset us.
Here's this thing.
I don't understand this design.
What is this?
That's how you get it, isn't it, Toh?
And you fill up the liquid right on the go.
Well, either you know it, the Moscow version. When you're stuck in traffic and you really need to go to the toilet, you just take it and that's it.
Well, guys, we met a shepherd on the way. We want to find out the way from him.
There he is, chasing sheep.
You pull like this,
gently, gently, gently.
Oh.
Hello. How are you? What's up? How's your health?
Is everything okay?
Yes, how did you come up here?
Came from Astana.
We're heading towards Baikonur.
We want to reach the hangar, you know, with the Buran. spaceship.
Baikonur.
Is Baikonur that way?
Yeah.
So we're going the wrong way?
Yeah.
The woman didn't tell us the right way. She said there.
Kazalins and then straight.
You think we can drive straight to Baikonur by car?
Yes, yes.
Can we get right to the spaceship?
No, to the city.
Where's the place where they launch rockets? We wanted to go there.
Here, it's a secret one.
Secret? Oh, so we can't go by car?
Yes, yes, yes.
Here we go.
There is a checkpoint in Baikonur.
How can we go around it without being caught?
I don't know, it's secret.
All right, bro, come on, have a nice day. Good day. So we need to go to the other way. Damn, okay.
Have a good trip.
The granny did not show us the right way. It's just that the locals know how to get there.
Will they give us lamb?
What? A lamb?
Will they give us a lamb? You asked a lamb, didn't you?
Do you want a lamb? What are you gonna do with it?
No, I thought you wanted to. Oh, does this thing work? Can I check out?
Guys, this is a military life hack.
Yeah, what's it called?
This is what the special services use. What is added to the Coke?
Coffee.
Coffee. Give me a little slurp. I just want to analyze it.
Take it. Analyze.
Damn, I forgot to ask how much a ram costs. Can we buy it or not?
Why? Better than any energy drink.
Damn, how much coffee do you put in there? It's nuclear.
In short, it is 500 times better than Red Bull, than adrenaline, and anything like that.
How do you know this life hack?
This is what special forces use.
Look, just a little bit. It's strong.
Just a little. Not much at all. Just take a sip.
There's a lot of coffee.
So small. You can't drink too much. That's it. That's it. Come on, stop.
Don't even feel the bitterness. Cool.
Great stuff. I told you it's better than Red Bull. Turns out cheaper.
Let's get started.
So, to start, we need to remove it from the speed. Otherwise, you would have rolled down the slope.
We started. It starts like a watch, like a Bentley.
First, and let's go. Slightly push the clutch. One more time. Turn off the turn signal. That's all. And now we have a box machine.
It will turn on now, damn it. You don't feel the revs at all? Let's go. Alright, let go.
It won't turn on. The TEVs are low.
Oh, I've made it.
That's it. The goddamn box machine. This is the military development of the UAZ.
Guys, we've spotted camels.
Damn, we can't turn around, right?
Oh no, to the right.
We'll turn around now.
Yes, yes, yes. There's just no cars around, and the song is just right.
One humped and two humped. This one is rare.
No way.
You just drive across Kazakhstan, cross the field, and then you're like, what a camel.
And what is Exol? Is this a local store?
We need to find a way.
Stop, I'll shoot it. Quiet, quiet.
Shh.
Don't be a coward.
Oh man, look how it looks, like a llama.
Well, it's got a face. It's already aiming to spit.
Okay, I should get glasses on then.
Damn, if you try to sit on it.
No, no, what are you doing? Don't even think about it.
If he spits, it will be disgusting.
Actually, you'll drown.
And by the way, can we feed them something?
Don't.
Come on, let's give them some yogurt.
Creepy's call.
Oh well, I think it's goats. Apparently the wolf stole and ate it.
Oh, how far do they spit? What a spread do they have?
Well, I don't know.
If he spat at you, do you have to duck? Or what should you do?
You can't dodge it, I think.
What a beauty.
You want to feed it with some grass?
Look at that. There aren't even any leaves. It's stiffened. Doesn't it eat it?
No, they choose a green one.
Guys, I managed to get closer. Look how huge it is.
You can see he's chewing something in his mouth right now. It's not grass. He's not eating anything right now.
He's chewing his saliva to spit at me right now. Because I got very close to him. Oh. Well, I'm really scared.
What do you think? The camel spits. Will the saliva reach Antoha or not?
You know what confuses me? They chew that hay like they want to spit right now.
Yes.
Not hay, but they're just chewing something. I was afraid, so I stepped back a little. He's got his head stretched out like a llama, and he's looking at me. He's gonna spin.
Never mess with camels.
Look at his house. It's cool, futuristic. Stairs with an access to the roof.
This is a guest house, a local one.
Cool light bulbs. They even got some design going on here.
Is the music fine?
Well, yeah.
Did you get your hair cut on purpose? Well, it seems like we're already close. Soon the road will be dug up. And this moat, in fact, separates the free territory of the protected one.
There are 500 meters left before the exit.
Before the exit of the road.
Anton, don't go too fast. We're about to enter the exit. Now we'll find out where we can do the exit.
Look, it's all been rummaged through. So the stalkers don't go there.
This is the road we need.
This one?
Yes. Let's wait it out when the stream leaves.
So they can see us. There's a convoy of vehicles coming. We don't want them to see us. What do you think?
A little worried.
Will they catch us right away or everything will be fine?
I think that everything will be fine, but we are behaving good.
It's just a little bit illegal.
Look, look.
You watch what he does. Shoot it, shoot it.
Wow, damn it. Passed through a solid road.
And I shot it. This is illegal. That's where we're going, Anton. On the road over there. Yeah, go. All right, everyone don't distract me.
Now is a very important moment, guys.
Scary, very scary.
After this moment, we will already behave like stalkers. Quiet, don't make any noise. Do not yell.
Guys, we're starting.
Quiet, quiet, quiet.
Take your time, take your time.
Oh, man, we're tilted.
What? What?
See? It's a little track.
Someone has already used this way.
Stalkers.
Stalkers. We need to get off the highway faster.
Left.
This is a secret stalker road. We will use it to enter the territory of the protected Baikonur Cosmodrome.
We need to get out of here very quickly, otherwise we will be noticed.
Yes, we clearly can be seen. Everyone looks at us like, damn, what are they doing there?
If only no one called the cops.
First obstacle, we go around it.
Come on, go around.
Here on the right. To the right is better.
Here, here's the road we need.
We're going straight to the right now, yes?
Yes.
We need to go faster. You can see us from the highway. We need to get out of here faster. Anton is getting nervous. Come on, come on. There it is, we're done.
Look, are there any cops?
No,
it's all good.
Please don't make a fuss.
Quiet, quiet. They can still see us from the highway, remember?
They can see us.
Sonya, do you want a joke? The cop's vehicle looks exactly like ours.
Really?
Yes, that's right. Just like that. That is, the Kazakhs will be afraid of us now.
Guys, am I turning off the lights?
Sure.
In fact, if suddenly the Kazakh police go off the highway, they'll see our car and think that we're Russians.
Yeah, like guarding their Baikonur? Are we going the right way? Are you checking the navigator?
Everything is smooth, Sasha, don't worry.
And why is the road so clear? Are we not the only ones driving to Baikonur?
A well-trodden road is good. The only thing that bothers me is the dust in the back.
Is it too dusty?
Look, look at the dust in the back.
Look, we're overcoming the trenches. First. Well, they have already been rolled. Isn't it a protective moat?
But this is not a moat, of course. It's just a designation of the territory that was here exactly. We are at a secret facility.
Do not dust too much.
A little to the left now, Anton.
Reinhard, usually the guys go to Baikonur on foot.
Right.
How many kilometers do they walk?
About 60 to 80 kilometers.
Holy crap.
It's a round trip. Look at the road and don't get too distracted.
So guys, here we are. And now we need to check through binoculars that are flashing right ahead. We have such a cool military binoculars.
Wow, it's pot-bellied. Wait, you need to configure it. So I see the hills, I see the road.
The main thing is that there's no one. Any cars?
The road is clear, I just checked.
Damn, how cool it is when it has such a zoom.
Did you turn on the zoom?
It's crazy.
Now let's check outside.
Look, is there a village or something?
Gosh, you can't see the highway anymore. This is steep all around. In all directions.
You're sitting on the salon and Stas goes like, you know what I'm worried about right now? For the fact that the sand will get in this hole.
In the hole?
In the hole, yes. And he says, give me the duct tape. I'll wrap it up right now.
Look, there's a gerboa. Maybe we should put some bread in there and it will come out. Make sure it doesn't bite your hand off. They're gerboa, they're so mean. Reinhardt, what is it? Clear?
Wait a minute, man. You've upset those binoculars.
What about you? Will you wrap it with a duct tape?
What if it gets in there?
Sand?
Of course.
We'll get straight into the engine, you know?
I don't understand anything. I don't know anything about cars at all.
It's a blown-up mine, you say?
Yes, that's right. Where?
Do we see it? 145th layer?
Turns out that it's all screwed up.
I mean, what? Shoot it, or nobody will believe.
All this is a distance that I have isolated. It's completely full of holes. That is, the crack went all over the hose.
Well, wrap it well.
And I can do it. Honestly. I can't do all the fixing stuff.
I found a hose. I'm gonna show it to Slava. Slava, we are saved. I found it too. This is the right one. The diameter.
Look, it's, you know, brass. Brass. Should we take it? It's expensive.
Let's all go then. Don't get lost.
You'll get a little punishment here. Here, for this.
I'm going to my friends. You kidding? We have to wipe a very small hole. Someone will lie down and look through binoculars.
Is everything okay? You can see, right?
Look, I can't see. Started up normally?
Yeah, smoothly.
So, it turns out that there will be a shift change in an hour. Security will change. In short, they have a shift change at 5. And we have caught this time. As they say, by the horns, and we will try to try our luck. That's how the whole road looks like. Constantly a dirt road. Very dusty. No trees at all. A huge plain.
Imagine a cop's car driving from there.
Imagine them coming right to us.
It'll be tough. Take your time, so that you can't roll back.
If someone is there, yes? So what, are we going to drive away? There is one road. Where are we going to hide here?
Well, just drive off to the sea, over this hill. Can't see us there. On the right side, we'll come down like this. And tow up, put the car at an angle.
I got it. I think they have not yet understood the seriousness of the situation. You don't understand, really.
We'll be on launch pads, then you'll understand, guys.
So, the inspection. There's serious business here, and you're laughing. It's goddamn security. Straight ahead, a little to the left. I think I can see the post.
That's a caller of patrol vehicles.
Does it move?
No, no, it stands still.
Go.
Come on, everyone.
It's scary, isn't it?
Well, yes.
Why don't you take off your mask? There's no COVID in here.
What if you're ill?
Is everything all right in the back, in the hole?
It's all good.
What about dust?
Very little dust. By the way, the hole is apparently the most basic topic of today.
Sasha, it's a part of a rocket. Where?
It's just a pipe. Look, this is the part of the rocket. Piece of iron.
Where? Oh, that's probably a section that's blown off when they launched it. Let's go out and take a look. I think the rocket exploded. What is this?
What? Try a radio phone on it.
I can, but I have it there. Look, this is a special material. Fiberglass, heavy duty and very light. What it was, I wonder. This is some part of the missiles. Here's the number. Number 74, guys. Has it been lying here so long? Did they use the composite material in the 74th? Turn it over.
It is layered.
Yes, look, there are some fasteners. Everything was torn off. There were sensors here. I'm afraid to touch it. What if it has radiation? Not at all. It's clean. Well, of course. The fuel was clean. Not radioactive. Let's give him some money for memory.
What was that?
Money for memory.
What is it?
This is a toolkit. I took it.
Is this for disassembling missiles? Yes.
Yes, we can't just leave. We need to take a souvenir with us. Back and forth.
He decided to unscrew the hose from the Buran and insert it here.
Listen, it turns out this tube is from someone's spaceship. I don't know.
It could be radioactive. We took it so easy.
Well, you check it out. What if they're getting contaminated right now?
Well, I don't think so.
There, you see? There they are, the starting tables.
Oh, starting barrel, guys.
Not barrels, but tables.
Oh, I see. That's where the tower is, right? Oh, there they are. Damn it. I saw a whole bunch of them. Everyone has their binoculars. Did you see barrels?
Well, I saw. These are actually active sites. Beginning of the active sites.
Are they?
It turns out that for this all the time, in short, we're going around them.
They seem so close, but they don't really see us, right? I hope. Well, it's better not to stand for a long time. Take a look and leave.
There's an undirected rocket.
Can I take a look?
Sure.
You can't see the security booth there. It's on the pillars. It's right in the middle.
In the back, guys, look, there's something there.
It's close.
41st Parade Ground, here on the right. The guards are moving there.
Is this the city of Baikonur, yes?
No, the city of Baikonur was left behind.
Oh, abandoned buildings. Sasha, look.
Cool.
I can see them so well.
That's the Zoom.
People used to live there. There are dorms and a university there. Look, this is your landmark on the left. See that last one?
It looks like the lights are on.
Yes, it is there, but it's not that.
What are you doing here?
Ask Anton. He has a BDSM vehicle here.
The children are watching us and you're acting like this.
I mean, why is it made here?
And wait, the cops have the same car.
What do they do here?
Anton, we will soon be driving off-road.
Nice beat up.
Well, so far, yes.
We decided to go off the highway, is that for sure?
Yes, yes.
Are you sure? What are we going to go off-road?
We are off-road. We need to go straight to the sun.
Yeah, bro.
Crazy.
Just keep it straight.
Between these buildings here, couldn't we have gone straight on?
No way.
No, there's no way here.
This is crazy, and we still have a long way to go.
We're going so slow.
Oh, you damn it.
Oh, what is it?
So far, everything seems to be fine.
This is not a country road. This is the real asphalt.
Real
asphalt. How do we get on it? I think we're going the wrong way. This can't be happening. It means it's active. But it's like a long time ago, but they have patrol. Look, it's rolled up.
Reinhard, I wouldn't stay here long. The road is paved and there are signs that patrols sometimes pass by.
Now I'm looking at the rolling road. We will go around it in case of something. Guys, it's the last resort. We'll go to the steep and spend the night there. Not, we'll go at night if we can see the moon shining. We'll soon be above us.
Wow. There's such a dead silence here.
Is the angle okay?
Yes.
Guys, the car is coming here. Let's go faster. Anton, quickly. Cameras, take the cameras. Faster, faster. Come on, where to? Straight, across the moat. Over there. Just get out of here. Faster, faster.
Straight where?
Straight, straight.
Guys, you all jumped in a car very quickly.
Yes, because there is a car on the left.
Straight. Don't turn on the lights, Anton.
Sure, and damn, the brakes can't give us out.
Do not slow down. It is better to roll.
Drive there. Oh, there's a moat here.
There's a moat here.
Okay, calm down. Calm down. We'll pass.
The car is coming.
Yes, yes. We're going to the highway. We have patrols. Joke is already over.
Maybe they're heading to us, no?
They're coming our way.
But were they far away?
They were far away. I caught them with my binoculars. To us, from the starting sights.
What is it?
It's a tool. Did you guys take everything?
Yes, yes.
Damn, it's scary. Are we holding the right angle?
Can we be chased now?
I don't know.
Well, I don't think we can hide that far away. It's open country here.
No, well, we can hide somewhere in the lowlands. We can't be seen from afar away. I don't think they're gonna search the field.
To the hill?
Yes, yes, yes. Here, yes. Here, stop.
It didn't stop for long. Reinhard went back to check.
No, well, the wheels are just insane.
Damn, the tracks are visible. The patrol is coming.
Is it coming?
Yes.
To us?
Now direction.
Seriously?
Yes.
So what?
We're done now?
No, we're not. Come on, over there, Anton, quickly.
We went in like mad.
Come on, come on, come on.
Look, hold.
Oh, good. Oh, we can go to the road. On this one.
Ah, what a thrill.
That's a brain shake.
This is cool.
Because they see the rear lights immediately.
We can't stop.
I can't hit the brake.
But we have duct tape to cover them up. We're gonna stop now in the hill.
Here, over there, see? Up and down, and sideways to the left. Slow down, slow down, slow down.
Will we stop here?
Damn, we ran into a hole.
Crazy.
It's insane, I hope everything is intact here. I won't jam the car then.
Well, yes, we'll go now, I hope.
Should we cover the rear lights?
With what? Duct tape? And this is what we're doing right now. Anton is sticking duct tape on the rear light so that they cannot see the stop lights.
Fortunately, this is a UAZ and there is only one rear light works. One light.
Alright, guys, let's go.
That's it, so I squeezed the clutch, stuck the gear in,
slammed the door properly.
You hear? It's not a road. It's someone's path.
Well, yes,
the path. Stalkers or animals. Maybe there are some animals here.
Wolves. Maybe it was a wolf trail.
Reihard, we still have traces. Is there any way we can cover them up?
Well, no way, not an option. It'll be dark soon. You won't see us.
Now tracks? Only the wind will save us, Sasha. Just drive me across the steep on the field. That's a UAZ, bro. What is our reference point?
Landmark, those pillars over there.
Which one?
The central one.
The one that is now?
We unexpectedly stuck.
Sasha, give me the lights. I need to get a shovel.
Guys, we drove and drove and here is very loose sand. Look how we fell in there.
A wheel stuck,
right out of the blue. Do you see the pit there?
Strange, but what is it?
And then there's a whole network of chipmunk burrows and we fell.
The grip will be fine now.
I have wild jitters. Don't worry, you're with me, Anton.
Just imagine the atmosphere now. We are in the steep, virgin land. We are in the UAZ. This is insane. Look at this. See? There are lights. You probably see us. This is the active side of Baikonur. From here, rockets take off into space. The astronauts are flying to the ISS from here.
Can you imagine?
Here, here. Here we are. We're just driving on a UAZ right here, guys.
Alright, let's go.
Easy.
Well, guys, it's very dark. We drive on the navigator, almost in total darkness. Due to the moon, you can barely see the road. We drove up to our secret garage. It's a barbed wire, right?
We're going to investigate it.
Look how big the fence is.
That's it. Now let's see where the rays would come from.
Did you also take a club?
Sure.
Damn. What if there are wolves in the garage?
It will be very dangerous.
Guys, I certainly don't want to say anything, but I'll probably record a suicide video just in case. Because now we will go to investigate a place where we should park this UAZ. I go there with a knife, because maybe there are wolves sleeping there. I'm not sure if a snipe will help me or not, so maybe...
You're with me, Anton. Don't be pessimistic. Let's go.
In short, wishes good luck.
Come on, Anton. We better go in from the other side. Along like this. It's actually clean here.
Alright, guys. We found a way. See?
We thought it was a garage, but it turned out to be a secret bunker for launching nuclear missiles.